I'm Rachel, the Education Manager at Feiro Marine Life Center in Port Angeles, Washington. Today, we are going to explore an eelgrass bed at Hollywood Beach. Eelgrass is a true grass that grows in protected areas that have a sandy bottom. Eelgrass beds are an important habitat for many animals, including humans. Many fish, such as herring, spawn or lay eggs on eelgrass. The eelgrass provides shelter for young fish and invertebrates, that's animals without a backbone. Eelgrass beds are foraging or feeding areas for fish, invertebrates like crabs, and birds alike. The roots of the eelgrass helps hold the sand and sediment in place. These plants have the ability to reduce the force of wave energy. As a result, they can reduce coastal erosion, making eelgrass beds important for coastal communities. Even during the lowest tides, eelgrass beds are mostly underwater. In order to find the animals that live in the eelgrass, we are going to do a beach seine. To help with the beach seine, we have Tamara, Feiro's facilities director, and volunteers Chris and Justin. First, let's look at the tools we'll use for our seine. Most importantly, we have our seine net. This net is 6 meters, or about 20 feet. At the base of the net, there are weights attached. This helps keep the net tight to the bottom, while the top of the net has floats attached to keep the net from sagging in the water. Chris is collecting buckets of water so we can get any animal we collect back into the water as quickly as possible. We also have a tally sheet so we can document our collection. As part of our scientific collection permit, we have to report every animal we handle. It's time to start the seine, and Chris and Justin are doing the hard work of pulling the net through the water. This takes a bit of time, as you have to go slow enough to make sure the weights stay on the bottom. Otherwise, you won't collect very much. The net is full of algae. To keep everything in the net, Tamara lifts the bottom of the net up to make it easier to pull the net onto shore. Now, the real fun begins. Buckets of cold salt water are moved to either side of the net, and everyone starts moving animals from the net into the buckets. Let's take a closer look to see what they're finding. Here, Tamara scoops up a wiggling pipefish to place in the bucket. The pipefish is a cousin of the seahorse. This long, thin fish swims vertically in the water and will sometimes wrap its tail around the eelgrass, just like a seahorse. The shape and color of this fish makes it almost disappear in the eelgrass. Do you see the pipefish's eye in the center of this photo? Look at how perfectly its body matches the eelgrass. You can see Tamara use the net to lift some grass shrimp into her hand. These grass shrimp are smaller than the tip of Tamara's pinky. You can frequently find these shrimp holding on to blades of eelgrass. These shrimp are an important food source for many of the fish that live in the eelgrass. The algae is moved one piece at a time to make sure all animals can be found. And under the pile of sea lettuce, we found a Dungeness crab. This feisty young crab is probably 2 or 3 years old and is going to skip the buckets and be directly returned to the harbor. Look, a shiner perch can be seen swimming across the net. Chris is pointing out some pipefish that are hiding next to the algae. He's going to use a net to carefully scoop the 3 pipefish up. Now that all the animals have been collected, Tamara goes through each bucket to identify all the animals while I record on our tally sheet.
1, 2, 3, 4, 10 points. A young sculpin and a tube snout.
After each animal is counted, they get sorted into one bucket that is taken back to Feiro, and the other bucket is released back to the harbor. Back at Feiro, we can get a closer look at some of the animals that were living amongst the eelgrass, like this flatfish. Next to the young flatfish, we have four small pinpoint gunnels. These eel-like fish love to hide in the eelgrass. Many pinpoint gunnels are the same bright green as the eelgrass, but sometimes they can be olive green or brown. You can see how this one wraps its body around the eelgrass to stay in place. These tube snouts have already been moved into the eelgrass exhibit. Tube snouts are frequently mistaken for pipefish due to their similar body shape. Unlike the pipefish, these tube snouts swim horizontally and are unable to wrap their tail around the eelgrass. These tube snouts were quick to find the brine shrimp and mysis shrimp that we put in for feeding. Watch closely as they snap up these tiny shrimp.